Hello students, so this is next online class on the same chapter determinant. So in my previous video we have solved few questions from exercise 5a, 5b and 5c. So today we are going to discuss the properties of determinant. Okay, so this exercise is very important and every exam we get one or two questions from here. So in terms of proving part, in terms of like you get the value of a determinant by using properties. Okay, so let's start our today's class. So you see I have noted down here p1, p2, p3, p4. That means here this is property number 1. Property number 1 says that suppose we have one determinant 1, 2, 3, 0, 0, 0, 1, 4, minus 1. Okay, so you see if any of the row or if any of the column is 0, all the 3 elements are 0, then the value of that determinant will definitely be 0, right? So the value of this determinant is 0. Now for example, if we have here 0, 0, 0, 2, 0, 4, 3, 2, minus 1, now the value of this determinant will also be 0. That means whether it be row or whether it be column, if all the 3 elements are 0, then the value of that determinant will also be 0. So this was property number 1. Next property says that suppose we have one determinant here, make it in a parallel, because last class I told you that if it is a square then it will come under matrix. Okay, so more or less few properties are same. You can get the same property in matrix, but as we are in determinant chapter, so and make it in parallel. Okay, so this property is valid for the matrix also. So matrix one we will see later on. So if we have one determinant 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9, so these are the 9 elements of this determinant. Now if you change rows into column and column into rows, the value of the determinant remains unchanged. Okay, so if you find the value of this determinant, the value of this determinant and value of this determinant will remain same. See what we have done, 1, 2, 3 was in row 1, now this has been changed into column 1, that means 1, 2, 3. So 1, 4, 7 is being changed into row, right? That means rows are changed into column, columns are changed into row. So you see how it is being done. Suppose we have this one, we need to get this, okay? So first 1, 2, 3 was there, so 1, 2, 3. And 1, 4, 7 was in row, so 1, 4, 7 will write as it is. Diagonal elements will be remaining as same. If you write the diagonal elements, it will remain same. So 8 will change its position, 6 will change its position. Then we will get. So this type of determinant, their values remain same. That means if rows and columns are interchanged, the total value of the determinant will be same. Okay. So next property we'll see, that is property number 3. Property number 3 states that if any elements of row or column, if it changes its position by one step, then there will be a negative sign in front of the determinant. That means the value will remain same, but there will be a negative sign, right? See once here, example 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So 1, 2, 3, these elements, column 1 element has moved to column 2 and column 2 has came to column 1. You see, there is a shift. So shift by how many step? One step. So therefore there is a minus sign. Now for example, if you need to change this 1, 2, 3 here, that means there will be 2 minus 1 whole square. That means minus 1. Now if there are 2 states are changing, now for example, if it stands like this, then there will be a minus 1 whole square. You see from the previous question, 1, 2, 3 was in column 1. Now at last step you see 1, 2, 3 is in the last step. So how many steps it has jumped? 2 steps. Therefore it is minus 1 whole square. If it is jumping 1 step, then minus 1. Similarly 1, 4, 7, if you change this one to this step, and 2, 5, 8 if you write here in the first row, then again there will be a minus. That means if any rows or column is changing by 1 step, there will be a minus 1. If it is jumping by 2 steps, then there will be minus 1 whole square. That means it will become a positive quantity, right? So this was property number 3. Next property we have, property number 4. If two rows or two columns in a determinant are identical, then the determinant equals to 0. So this states that, you see, if any rows or any columns, their values are same, identical means same here, therefore the value of the determinant will also be 0. Like you see, 1, 4, 1, 2, 5, 2, 3, 6, 3. Note, 1, 2, 3 is in column 1, 1, 2, 3 is in column 3. Therefore, the elements are identical. Same elements, both the columns are having. Therefore, the value of this determinant will also be 0. Similarly, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. You see, row 1 and row 2 have same elements. So, therefore, the value of the determinant is 0. So, directly we can write it here is 0. And just in the right hand side, we'll write the reason. As all the elements of row 1 and row 2 are identical, so value of the determinant is 0. So, likewise, we have to use these properties while solving our exercise problems. So, next property we have, property number 5. You see, let us consider we have a determinant del equals to a1, a2, a3, b1, b2, b3, c1, c2, c3, that is a 3 cross 3 determinant. Now, if we multiply any non-zero term, let us consider it will be k. So, k, I am multiplying here k a1, k a2, k a3, right? So, after multiplying k times of any element of any row, so when you multiply, we have to multiply either row in all the elements or all the columns, all the elements, right? So same element we have to multiply. Now after multiplication, what we have seen? So you see, previously k term was not there. Now after multiplication, we have a k term here. So from here, if we take k common, the value of the determinant will be del. So that means here, total value, what will be the origin, what will be the next value, that will be k times of original value. I repeat, initially let us consider del value if it is 2. So let us consider after calculation of this determinant we got 2. Now if we multiply k times here, so our next determinant, our final answer will be k into 2. This is what it is explaining, that if the original determinant, whatever may be the original determinant value, if we multiply any non-zero term in any row or any column, that means the resultant determinant answer will be k times to that of original determinant. Okay, now let's move to property number 6. Property number 6, you see, a1 plus x1, a2 plus x2, a3 plus x3, B1, B2, B3, C1, C2, C3. So this determinant can be also written as summation of two determinants. Like you see, in two determinants, you see B1, B2, B3, C1, C2, C3 is same here in the both the cases. What is the difference here? Only this part, that is A1, A2, A3 to be written in first determinant, X1, X2, X3 to be written in second determinant. That means when you add this one, we will be getting this resultant, okay? So not like that, b1 plus b1 to b1, no. So that is not in determinant property, okay? So the element will remain same, only once you need to write here. We will not be writing here 2, okay? So if a1 and x1, if row 1 elements of first determinant and second determinant, if it is different, then it will be written in summation. Otherwise, it will be remain as same. Next property, property number 7. Property number 7, it is saying that here a1, b1, c1, a2, b2, c2, if these are the 6 elements of 2 rows, row 1 and row 2, and row 3 can be, if it is written as, you see what operation we will be using here, row 3 we are changing, that means we will make change in row 3. So row 3 plus k row 1. Okay? See what I have written here, what changes I am making here, row 3, that means all the row 3 elements we will change. What change we will make? Row 3 plus k times of row 1, that means a3 plus k a1, b3 plus k b1, c3 plus k c1, okay. This operation we have applied here, so this will be the change, right. Now it is said that if we find the value of this determinant, and if we find a value of this determinant separately, both the answers, it has been seen that same. Okay, so that means this also being one property. Like you see, if any row is changing with k times of same determinant rows or columns, then the value of the determinants remain same. Okay, so this was the property number 7. Now you see, after explaining these properties, we will be solving few questions. okay, so these properties will be clear from there. Okay, so you, many students might have doubts in this property, which will be cleared when we'll solve few questions. Next property we have, you see, a1 plus la2 plus ma3, similarly b1 plus lb2 plus mb3, c1 plus lc2 plus mc3, a2 b2 c2 a3 b3 c3. So this value equals to a1 a2 a3 b1 b2 b3 c1 c2 c3. See what is here, a1 a2 a3 b1 b2 b3 c1 c2 c3. So it is said that if same element, if we multiply same element, we multiply with different rows and column and we add in column 1, then the determinants will look like this. See how we got this one, so we can prove also. So why it is like this, we will prove now, right? So you see, this determinant, first of all, we can write like this, a1, b1, c1. Next, a2, b2, c2, a3, b3, c3, right? Now, next, plus just now with this, this property, we are going to separate now. Next, we have to write here, l, a2, a2, a3, l, b2, b2, b3, right? L, c2, c2, c3. Okay, plus here we will be writing here m a3 m b3 okay m c3 a2 b2 c2 a3 b3 c3. Now you see this determinant I have written in three summation, right? First I wrote a1 b1 c1, a2 b2 c2, a3 b3 c3. Same I wrote l a2 l b2 l c2, a2 b2 c2, a3 b3 c3. Similarly m a3 m b3 m c3, a1 a2 b2 c2, a3 b3 c3, right? So I have written this determinant in three forms. Now you see, we can take in the next step, as there is no space here, just I will tell you here that in the next step what we can do, we can take L common from here, from this column. This is column 1, column 2, column 3. So from column 1, what we can take common? L we can take common. Now if we take L common here, so L will be written front, right? So like this we can take common from any row, and reason we have to write there, taking L common from column 1. Similarly what we can take here, M common from column 1. So if we take M common from column 1, that means in the next step we will have this. Okay, so when you write in your copy, you have to write the next step. Just here I am showing that after multiplying, after separating this one, so we have to take common in the next step. Okay, now you see a2, you see here this will be a1 actually, or it is a2 itself. So you see a2, a2, b2, b2, c2, c2. Did you see all the elements of column 1 and column 2, both are same, so value of this determinant will be 0. Similarly you see a3, a3, b3, b3, c3, c3, that is value of this determinant will be 0. So m into 0, 0, l into 0, 0. So ultimately what we will get, we will get this. Okay, so therefore this is the answer. Okay, so this is the answer, that means this equals to this. So we can say that if any same element is being multiplied with the other terms of the column, then the net determinant will be the first columns. Okay, so these are the properties. So one more property is there, property number 8, that is related to factors. That one we will understand while solving the particular questions. Okay, very few questions is based upon that property, so that property will be easily understood by solving those property. Okay, so few questions we have here. Without evaluating the problems 1 to 10, state why each statement is true.
ओके. सो फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन यू सी 2 3 1 0 0 0 माइनस 1 2 0 ओके इक्वल्स टू जीरो. सो दैट मीन्स ऑलरेडी द आंसर इज गिवन हियर जीरो. बट वी हैव टू से हाउ इट इज जीरो हियर. सो रीजन यू हैव टू गिव दैट ऑल द एलिमेंट्स ऑफ रो टू आर जीरो. सो द वैल्यू ऑफ द डिटर्मिनेंट इज जीरो. ओके नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन यू सी 3 1 3 0 1 0 1 2 1 दिस ऑल्सो जीरो. विल से द एलिमेंट्स ऑफ कॉलम 1 एंड कॉलम 3 आर आइडेंटिकल. Therefore, the value of determinant is zero. So that means each and every question we have to use that properties which I have explained now. Similarly, you see this one, all the elements of column 4 is zero. So the value of the determinant is zero. Right? Similarly here, 2, 3, 1, 1, 2, 3, 1, 1. You see, row 1 and row 3 elements are same, identical, so the value of determinant is zero. So like this, you need to write this determinant, you need to copy the question and you have to write the reason. So as you can see here, rows are changed into column, columns are changed into rows, so the value of the determinant is same. So that means this is from property 3 2 1, so 3 2 1, 3 4 5, so 3 4 5. That means simply you can see that rows are changed into columns, so the value of the determinant is same. So you have to write that property, okay, in words. So likewise for the other questions also. But you see question number B, we have 1 2 3 1 2 3 2 3 4 1 1 1 3 4 5 1 0 minus 1. So we have to prove this one. Okay, so this one I will solve on board. So this is the question, right? So you see in the question what it is written without actually expanding, that means we cannot find the value of this separately and value of this separately, and we'll say that both the values are same, so they are equal. No, we cannot do like this. We have to prove this one by using the properties only what I have explained now. Now you see, first of all, we have to make this one as 1 1 1, right? So 1, 2, 3, it is unchanged, right? So you see, if I need to make here 1, 1, 1, so what we have to subtract here? We have to change this row, that means R to a row. So in the previous question also, I told you, while explaining that properties, I told that whenever you are changing any row, column, then you have to mark that row, which row you want to change. That means I want to change this row, row 2. That means row 2 error. Okay. Now what changes I need to make here? That means row 2, I need to subtract row 1. From row 2 element, I need to subtract row 1. That means 2 minus 1, 1. 3 minus 2, 1. 4 minus 3, 1. Right? So therefore, we are changing this operation. We will apply here. So what we will get here? So we have taken LHS. Okay. So this is the question. And I have taken LHS and solving. Now at last we will prove this one. So 1, 2, 3, I have made these changes. So this will be 2 minus 1, 1, 3 minus 2, 1, 4 minus 3, 1, right? Now, what changes we will make here? Row 3 we will change here. Now, in row 3 we will change, what changes we will make here? 2, 2 to 4, 4 minus 1. Now you see, R2 I will take. Minus 2. So here I will not apply that both the steps together. You see, just row 2 I have applied here, and this one to be written as it is, right? Now here you see 1 2 3 1 1 1, or we have matched. Now last we have to prove this one, 1 0 minus 1, in terms of 3 4 and 5. So what we will do, we are not changing any row 1 and row 2, so that to be written as it is. So here we have to make changes in row 3, that means row 3 arrow, that means 4 into row 2 minus row 3. We will do these changes. Okay, that is 4 into root 2, that means 4 ones are root 2 is 1, that means 4 ones are 4, 4 ones are 4, 4 minus 3, that is 1, 4 ones are 4, 4 minus 4, 0, so 4 ones are 4, 4 minus 5, that is minus 1, okay, so equals to RHS. So likewise, we have to use here operation here. So these are called the operations, that is addition and subtraction operations. So one thing you note here, first 1, 2, 3 was same, so I wrote as it is. Now 2, 3, 4, I need to make here 1, 1, 1. So what operation I have taken here, R2 minus R1. So each element we will subtract and we get 1, 1, 1. Now after getting 1, now we need to change this one also. We have to change in terms of 1, 0, minus 1. Now you have to see that what you will multiply and from which row or column you will subtract in order to get this one. So I have got here 4 ones are 4, that means I am multiplying 4 in row 2. 4 ones are 4, 4 minus 3, that is 1. 4 ones are 4, 4 minus 4, 0. 4 ones are 4, 4 minus 5, that is minus 1, right? So same element should be multiplied in any row or column in order to get the same answer, okay? So the result might be same, so we have to see that what element we have to multiply in each element of the particular row or column. So next question we have, question number 2, 42, 28, 14, 173, 642, we have to prove it 0, right? So first of all you see, what we can take common from here. So 7 are the factors of all these 3 elements. Now if I take 7 common, that is you see, or you can say here 7, if I take common here, that means 7 6 is 42, 7 4 is 28, 7 2 is 14, and 1 7 3 6 4 2, right? See here, from here what I have taken common, 7. Now you see all the elements, so 7 into 0 it will be 0 here. Now reason you will say, all the elements of row 1 and column 1 and column 3 are identical. So this one you need to write. Okay? So this is our answer. So we have to prove by writing its properties. So next question we have 1 by a square bc, 1 by b square ca, 1 by c square ab, okay, we need to put this one as 0. So this can be done, what we will do, you see, we have to see the pattern first, the pattern is abc, okay, so only we have bc here, that means what is not there, a is missing here, b is missing here and c is missing here, so what we will do, multiplying a, b and c in row 1, row 2 and row 3 respectively. This one we have to write. So that means we are multiplying a into row 1, we are multiplying b into row 2 and we are multiplying c into row 3. Okay, so after multiplication a and a gets cancelled, so what we will get here, 1, we will get a cube, we will get abc, b and b will get cancelled, 1, b cube, abc, c and c will get cancelled, we will get 1, c cube, abc, okay, and in the next step we will take abc common. Now one thing you note, when you are multiplying a, b, c in row 1, row 2 and row 3, make sure you divide by ABC also. Okay? So when you multiply, like for example, you have multiplied A in row 1, that is 1 by the outside. B when you are multiplying in row 2, that is 1 by B. C when you are multiplying, 1 by C. That means therefore we will get 1 by ABC. Now here we have ABC here. In the next step, what we will do? We will take ABC common from column 3. Taking ABC common from C3 is column 3. So already one ABC was there previously. Now when I take common, we will get here 1, 1, 1, A3, B3, C3, and all the elements will become here 1, 1, 1. Right? So ABC and ABC will get cancelled, and all the elements of column 1 and column 3 is identical, so value is 0. So again, all the elements of C1 and C3 are identical. Okay, this reason you have to write. Therefore, the value is 0. So this question also we have to prove here 0. So this is the question number 3. So in order to prove here 0, we will use few operation now. This is row 1, row 2 and row 3. Let us consider we need to change this row 1. So if you need to change here row 1, so row 1 equals to row 1 minus row 3. Okay, we are making these changes. Okay, let me apply, then I will tell why we have taken this step only. Okay, similarly I need to change this row 2, row 2 minus row 3. Row 3 is unchanged, so this will be as it is. Okay, so 0 minus R1 minus R3, R1 we have 0 minus R minus P. Similarly, P minus Q minus R minus Q. P minus R minus 0. Similarly here, Q minus P minus R minus P. 0 minus R minus Q. Q minus R minus 0. Okay, so these are the changes we made. Now you see, when you multiply minus inside, what you will get here? P minus R. Okay, that means P will become positive, R will become negative, P minus R. Similarly, if you solve this one, P minus Q minus R minus minus plus Q, that means you will get cancelled. What you will get here? P minus R. Similarly, we have P minus R. Now you have understood why I have subtracted row 1 with row 3 only. Because when you subtract, it has been seen that all the elements will give same result. That is why I have subtracted R1 minus R3. Now similarly, we will see for this R2 also. Q minus P minus R plus P, that is, will get cancelled. What I will get here? Q minus R. Similarly, if I take a minus, that means we will get Q minus R and Q minus R, right? And this one will remain as it is. Okay? In the next step, this equals to means the next step, we will taking P minus R and Q minus R common from R1 and R2 respectively. You need to write this respectively, otherwise if you don't write, this will make a sense that P minus R and Q minus R you are taking common from both R1 and R2. That means this is present in R1 and R2, which is wrong. So when we write respectively, that means first one we take common from first row, second one we take common from second row. Okay, respectively you have to write. So when you take common, that means P minus R and Q minus R is in front. So we will get 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, and R minus P and R minus Q and 0, right? So this value will be 0, because P minus Q, in the next step you will write P minus R, Q minus R into 0 equals to 0, because all the elements of row 1 and row 2 are identical. So likewise, we have proved this value of this determinant is also 0. So when the question is that without expanding, prove that this determinant value is 0, so we need to apply the properties here. Okay, see, here we have applied the properties, that identical property, and here we have to first bring it in the general form. Okay, so if you are directly unable to get the property, if you see that property is not applicable here, so first you have to bring that in a general form, then we have to apply the property. Okay, so next question we have, left hand side we have 1 x plus y x square plus y square, 1 y plus z y square plus z square, 1 z plus x square plus x square, z square plus x square, and we have to prove this one, right? So in this type of question, in proof part question, we have to see what we want to get here, x minus y. Okay, so x minus y, how will you get from here? You see, if we subtract, now when in any first, I'll tell you the trick here. If any question when you are proving here, you see the left hand side equals to right hand side, we have to prove, and you see that right hand side is not zero. If right hand side is zero, then you think that you have to apply the property. Okay, directly you need to write the property, but here you see right hand side is not zero. So right hand side first we have x minus y, y minus z, z minus x, x minus y is there. Now you see that in the left hand side whether there is 1, 1, 1 or not. That means three elements are 1, 1, 1 or not. 1, 1, 1. Okay, it is in row 1. So it can be in column 1 also. Okay, if 1, 1, 1 is not present, then we have to make first 1, 1, 1. Okay, either by taking common or by subtraction. Okay. So in this question already we see that in row 1 we have 1, 1, 1. Okay. So out of 3, 1 we have to make 2, 0. Okay. I repeat, out of 3, 1 we have to make 2, 0. Now what? How will you make? You see, first of all, I need to make this one as 0 or this element as 0. That means row 1 I need to make here 0. Okay. So you see how we can get here x minus y, so row 1 we are changing with row 3, and row 2 I am changing with row 3. That means all the elements of row 1 I am subtracting from here, from row 3. Similarly, all the elements of row 2 I am subtracting from row 3. That means row 3 I have kept as a reference. Okay, so we can subtract r1 minus r2 also, R2 minus R3 also, but you see when we take 1 as a reference, then the solution becomes easy. Okay, so R1 and R2 we are changing, we are not changing row 3, right? So row 3 elements I will be writing as it is, first thing. Okay, I am not changing R3 here. Now row 1 what I am changing? R1 minus R3, that is 1 minus 1, 0. So x plus y, now we will see that x plus y minus z plus x, that means minus z minus x. So x and x word cancel, y minus z. So we need to write here y minus z. Now similarly, x square plus y square minus z square minus x square. So x square and x square got cancelled. What you will get here? Y square minus z square. Similarly, r2 minus r3, that means 1 minus 1, 0. Y plus z minus z minus x. And when you multiply minus, all the terms will be minus. So z and z got cancelled, we will get y minus x. Okay, similarly here what we will get here, y square plus z square minus x square. So we will get cancelled, we will get y square minus x square. Okay, so after subtraction we got this element. Okay, now in the next step what we will do, we will take here or we will expand this one in a formula. A square minus b square, a plus b, a minus b, y minus x, a plus b, a minus b, 1 z plus x, z square plus x square as it is. Okay, in the next step, we will take common, taking y minus z and y minus x common from row 1 and row 2. Okay, so from row 1 and row 2 I have taken y minus z and y minus x common. If I take common, so I need to write in front y minus z, y minus x. If I take here common, then what I will get here? 0, 1, y plus z, 0, 1, y plus x, 1, z plus x, z square plus x square. Okay, so when I will take common here, so this will be as 1 and this will become y plus z. Now we will expand. Okay, so on expanding, you know in the previous class I taught you how to get the value of any determinant. That means if I take here 0, 0 will be multiplied with this 4 element, minus 0, this position 0, again we will minor of this element, and last we will get non-zero term for this. That means 1, if I take here, if I hide corresponding row and corresponding column, what I will get here? 1 y plus z, 1 y plus x. Okay, if you face any problem, you refer my previous video first, okay, for getting this value of the determinant. Like for example, up to this step, if it is clear, first here I have written as it is. Now 0 I have taken. So once you take 0, you will hide corresponding row and corresponding column. You will get 1, y plus x, z square plus x square. Okay. Similarly, minus 0. Why it is minus? Because the position is minus. Its position is 2, 1. Okay, row number 2, column number 1. 2, 1. 2 plus 1, 3. As it is odd, so minus 0. If you hide this, you will get 1, y plus z. Okay, if you hide this and this, 1, y plus z, z plus x, z square plus x square. So 0 multiplied by something is 0. 0 multiplied by something is 0. So ultimately, we will get for this. So last step I will be solving here, you see, y minus z, y minus x, so this is 0, okay, and here 0 minus 0 plus 1. Now if you cross multiply, y plus x minus y minus z, so here y and y got cancelled, we got x minus z, that is y minus x, x minus z. Okay, so what was the proving part here? Proving part, we can see we had to prove here x minus y. Here when I see here, we have to prove x minus y, y minus z, and z minus x. Okay, so we had to prove this one. So when we had to prove this one, you see, if I take here minus common, then what I will get here? X minus y, y minus z, already it is there, z minus x. That means again, if I take z minus x, again minus, minus minus plus equals to RHS. Okay, that means sign this and this will be changed, and we can easily prove this one.
So similarly, we will solve questions for question number 3 also. You see, again we have to prove here 0. So this question, what we will do, we will take here row 3. Okay, we will first write LHS, then we will change here, we will apply one operation here, that is R3 arrow R3 plus R2. Okay, so when you will add this and this, what you will get here? A plus B plus C, A plus B plus C, A plus B plus C. Now A plus B plus C, you will take common, then you will get 1, 1, 1. So it will be identical with row 1. So value will be 0. Okay, so similarly, this one, row 1. So here we will add all row. First we will write LHS, then we will write R1 arrow, R1 plus R2 plus R3. So when you will add all three, what you will get here? 3x plus lambda, 3x plus lambda, 3x plus lambda. Okay, now 3x plus lambda you will take common, you will get 1 1 1. Then out of 3 1, you try to make 2 0. Okay, so likewise, so if you face problem, you see the hint is given in the question. So go through the example questions and try to do a few questions from here. Okay, so many questions are there, we'll do few questions and see the hint also. So in the next class, I will solve few questions from here and we will start matrices. Okay, so till then, goodbye.